Good morning, children. Welcome to the online class of Sri Gokulam Public School, Gurugram. I am Vijayalakshmi, your maths teacher. In the last class, we have learned the conversion of kilometer into meter, meter into kilometer, and how to express half of a kilometer, 1/4 of a kilometer, and 3/4 of a kilometer in meters. Isn't it? So I hope you have practiced problems from the textbook and you have written down the notes. So today we are going to learn the measurement of mass or weight and capacity and volume. Okay? So let us start, children. Now children, let us learn about the measurement of mass. Mass or weight. So do you know what weight is? How do we define it? Yes. Weight is the heaviness of an object. To see, it is to see how heavy an object is. Okay, so you already know that the standard units of mass or weight is kilogram and gram, and we know that 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams. 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram, and kilogram is expressed as kg and gram is expressed as g. So today we will learn how to convert kilogram into gram and gram into kilogram. Now in the previous class you have already learned how to convert kilometer into meter and meter into kilometer. So the same method is used here to convert kilogram into gram and gram into kilogram. Okay, so first let us convert kilogram into gram. So we have 6 kilogram, and we can convert it into gram by multiplying by 1000. 6 into 1000, which is equal to 6000 gram. Okay, so we have 7 kilogram and 125 gram. This can be converted as 7 kilogram plus 125 gram, and 7 kilogram can be written as 7000 gram. 7000 gram plus 125 gram, which is equal to 7125 gram. Okay, children? The same method is used here to convert, isn't it? So we can do the conversions in this way. Okay, now this is the conversion of kilogram into gram. Now let us see how to convert gram into kilogram. You have already learned how to convert meter into kilometer. The same procedure is used here, children, that is to divide by 1000. Okay, so now let us convert 6570 gram into kilogram. We already know that to convert gram into kilogram, we have to divide by 1000. So let us divide this by 1000. And you also know that when we divide a number by 1000, the digits in the ones, tens, and hundreds place form the remainder, and the rest of the digit form the quotient. So here the quotient represents kilogram. So we have 6 kilogram and the remainder is 570. So 570 forms the gram. So 6570 gram is equal to 6 kilogram and 570 gram. So I hope you have understood how to convert kilogram into gram and gram into kilogram.
Children, let us see the simplest method of converting kilogram and gram into grams. For example, 5 kilogram 325 gram can be put together and written as 5325 grams. Let us try out one more example. 3 kilogram and 5 gram, they can be put together as 3 and 005, because gram is expressed in 3 digits. So the answer is 3005 gram. Now let us see how to convert grams into kilograms and grams in a simpler way. Consider 4750 gram. The last three digits 750 can be written as grams and the rest 4 is written as kilogram. So we have 4 kilograms and 750 grams.
Children, we have 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. Okay. And in the previous video, we have learned that what is half of a kilometer? What is half of a kilometer? Yes, that is equal to 500 meters. Isn't it? So in the same way, we have half of a kilogram is equal to 500 gram. Half of a kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. Also, you know that what is 1/4 of a kilometer? We know that 1/4 of a kilometer is equal to 250 meter. So here also 1/4 of a kilogram is equal to 250 gram. Now the same way we know that 3/4 of a kilometer is equal to 750 meter. So 3/4 of a kilogram is also equal to 750 gram. There is only the change in the units. Okay. Now children, let us learn what is capacity and volume. The quantity of a liquid is called its volume. The capacity of a container is the volume of the liquid it can hold. Okay. So if I fill a water bottle with 2 glasses of water, we can say that the capacity of the water bottle is 2 glasses. But we have learned the standard units of capacity, isn't it? What are they? Do you remember that? Yes, they are milliliter and liter, isn't it? And do you know how much 1 liter is equal to? Yes, it is equal to 1000 milliliters. So 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliters, and milliliter is expressed in a short form as ml and liter is expressed as L. Okay. So to convert liter into milliliter, we have to multiply by 1000 as we did in the conversion of weight. And to convert milliliter into liter, we have to divide by 1000 the same manner as we did in the measurement of weight. Okay children, I will give you some examples to see the conversion. So now let me convert 7 liters to milliliters. So I have to multiply with 1000 and you get 7000 milliliters. Let us go for another example. 4 liters and 50 milliliters. We have to convert this into milliliters. We can see that already there are 50 milliliters. So we need to convert 4 liters to milliliters first. We know that 4 liters is equal to 4000 milliliters, isn't it? Plus 50 milliliters, and that is equal to 4050 milliliters. So this is the conversion of liter into milliliter. Now let us see how to convert milliliter into liter. So I need to convert milliliter into liter. So 4525 milliliter is equal to, you can divide it by 1000, and you know that when you divide by 1000, the last three digits, that is the digits in ones, tens and hundreds place, is the remainder and the rest 4 is quotient. So we have the quotient as liter and the rest remainder as milliliter. Also we can write 4525 milliliter as 4000 milliliter plus 525 milliliter, and that is equal to 4 liter and 525 milliliter. Okay children, I hope you have understood.
Liters can be converted to milliliters and milliliters can be converted to liters in the simplest form as we did for weight and length.
Now we already know that 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. So 1/4 of a liter is equal to 1000 divided by 4, which is equal to 250 milliliter, and half of a liter is equal to 500 milliliter, and 3/4 of a liter is equal to 750 milliliter. So we can express liters as milliliters very easily using this expressions. Okay, so children, I hope you have understood how to convert mass and capacity of objects, isn't it? So go through the YouTube video, write down the notes, and do more exercises from the text. Practice more problems, children. Also, please write down the notes regularly and also study well, because next year also you will be having a continuation of these topics. So see you again in the next class with another topic. Till then, goodbye. Stay safe and stay home.